which by skepticism, enthusiasm and antagonism has enriched the depth of the spiritual science, so that we have to prove ourselves by going to the depth. There is no other way. So it has compulsorily, necessitatively, it has made that. So these are all the benefits of this century. Only this century we are having that. If it is before 5 or 6 centuries, we were totally different. If it is even the before century, we were unprocessed. So the baby of the modern century was unconceived before few centuries. It was not undelivered before. It was totally undelivered before a single century. Now it is a delivered baby. It was unconceived before 5 or 6 centuries. In the previous century, it was undelivered. Now the labor is over and now we are at the exact necessity level. And what are the 5 major things that urge us to go for spiritualism? Only India can give the answer. One is bodily health and longevity. Lot of pharmaceuticals that somebody has told. About 1.4 million people, they have gone bankrupt only on the case of medical expenses. At United States of America, where there is Harvard University, Stanford University, and various other centers of lore, advanced lore, in spite of which 1.4 million people, they have gone bankrupt. So these growing diseases, uncontrollability over medicines, and incredibilities or irresponsibilities in drug companies and fraudulences, and the repatriation of the diseases in spite of medication, insecurity in surgical and drug responses, all of these things has resulted in the formation of only a spiritual solace. Only God could save us and not a doctor and medicine. Either they can support, if I want to live, either God must support or he must be a substitute for the medicine. Either God must support the medicine and doctor, or totally I must be away from doctor and medicine so as that I can survive. There is a book written by a very famous person. He has written Death by Medicine. He has written lot of people dying only because of medicine, not by doctor. That's what I told on the medical seminar. I told when a patient was asked by some other patient, when the doctor is discussing with the prescription or other things, he told what is happening. The person was asked, what is happening there? 4 D's are discussing. Doctor, drug, disease and my destiny. They are discussing what to do with me. So this physical inability, that is the first reason. And second thing is mind. We are having workload. We are having lot of workload. We are having tension. And there is no process. There is no psychotropic drug which has given you proper solace or proper comfort. So the body, its deterioration is the first reason to approach India for spiritual solace. The second thing is the whole world is suffering due to tension. Each and every house has a psychopath and psychiatrist at US. And there is no proper harmony in the society at all. Growing mental diseases, mental tensions, continuous race in pursuit of wealth. In pursuit of wealth, compromising one's own health, spoiling one's own mind, not concentrating on the tools for developing mind, that has resulted in the formation of mind-related problems, which has tempted the person to go for a paramaterial or supermaterial relief. That is the mind. The third thing is relations. There is no relation at all. There is no relation at all. Each and everybody, they live only with the 2 circumstances. The human beings, they live under only 2 circumstances. One, just as a security to the house, or one more member, instead of avoiding solitude, one more member is required in the house. They want somebody for taking care of the possessions in the house. One. Number 2, they are afraid that they must be alone in the house. So for that, there is some other person distinguishable from the pillar and concrete structure of the house. So this is how they are having. Second thing, for social show, they are having relations in which they behave like Tom and Jerry inside and behave like Sita and Rama outside. So there are no proper relations. What are the 6 major instincts which give you relations? There are 6 instincts which can give you relations. You must note down certainly, it is a way of life. Number 1, adjust. 2, agree. 3 is advise. 4 is forget. 5 is forgive. 6th thing is love. So love the other person, agree with some person on only agreeable conditions, agree with the person, adjust with the person. Agree is accepting, adjusting is not protesting, it is different. So agree with the person, adjust with the person, just to show your legal and reasonable intrusion for their betterment, that is known as advice. Forget something so that you can be happy. Forgive something so that we can be happy. And love them so that they can be cured more by love. These 6 instincts are known as the greases of human mind. They are known as the greasy substances of human mind, which reduces friction or which avoids friction in relations. That thing is not there. That's why there are only 2 options. You have to cry. You have to hug somebody and cry. You have to sleep in somebody's lap and you have to shower your joy. You have to speak with somebody. You have to burst your emotions to somebody. There are only two options in the society. One is G-O-D, second is D-O-G. So, you have to rare pets and you have to cry or you have to laugh with them. Second thing is you have to surrender to God and you have to submit to Himself. So, this type of relations, mismanagement. So, no person in the small age, by means of nutrition, physiological evolution, psychological status, they are not trained to get these six instincts. They must be given sattvic food, sattvic dhyana and practices. You are not giving anything. Then after the person is grown, why you are blaming that he is not taking care of me? Is there any parent or is there any couple, those who have trained the people by means of various samskaras or by puja vidhanas or dhyanas or by proper ahara diksha, that they will be very much affiliation, very much dependence, very much obedience, subservience, all of these qualities can be felt in later. So you have not sown any seed, what you can come for harvesting? So third thing is relation. Fourth thing is depletion of nature. So nature was told to be God. That is in depletion. So there is only one thing beyond depletion, that is a purna, complete God. So nature has also abandoned us. So we have to go beyond nature, paranatural realm. That is the instinct of God. And that is the force of the divine. So that is there. And the fifth thing is national and international issues, global issues, even like terrorism, drug addiction, even global warming, and various other things are there pestering the society. These five things, because of the mind, because of the body, because of the relations mismanagement, because of the global issues, and because of the nature's repletion, we have no other go except to go for God. And for that, we have to go for spiritual lineage and scriptural lineage. Acharya parampara and Shastra parampara. Scriptural lineage and spiritual lineage. And the only place, only abode in the world where we can have uninterrupted, blemishless lineage of scripturalism and spiritualism is our land. So India Century Mission is justified. So apart from this, now the whole world, they have invented TV, they have invented plasma, they are going to Mars, they have done everything. But there are some instincts which have governed the present society. Everything has become very common and usual. Everything that was at the time of inceptive stage of inventions, whenever they are seeing TV, they saw like there is some alien. Seeing computers, seeing everything was considered to be something different, something great and something worthy of exclamation before few centuries or few decades. Now we have seen everything. Everything has become very common, number one. Number thing, we have exhausted. Totally we have exhausted and we have been exhausted. But third thing, instead of getting an attractive dimension, now everything is giving a tedious and monotonous dimension. So first thing, everything has become common. And second thing, everything has become monotonous. The third thing, we have exhausted and we are totally frustrated and tired and seeing the developments, hearing this thing. Our level of curiosity is subjected to the law of diminishing nature. Now it is dropping towards zero. At one stage, we are going to totally dislike everything and we are now developing an unintentional, unknowing, nostalgic sense to go back to our culture and tradition and heritage inside our mind. So unavoidably, whether you like it or not, all the computers will be replaced by portraits of gods. Our computers will have portraits of gods on them. On the desktop and screen top. There is no other option. Because over-exertion, monotonous way of these things, and also very commonality and casual way of viewing these things for several decades together, it has been progressing in such a manner that we have started hating it, or we have started to make a very casual and ordinary prosaic look on all of these things. And in ancient timings, the God or the system of our religion that taught only two ways of life. One, you enjoy the life, or you suffer for enjoying the life. There are only two things. One is enjoy. Second is to suffer by hard work, hard learning. Suffer and then as a result of your suffering, just as a pregnancy as a pain and delivery is a pleasure. Surgery is a pain and relief or total recuperation of your health is the pleasure. So ancient system, they thought only two things. One, have pleasure by means of limited knowledge, limited execution, contentment and other qualities. The second thing is suffering. Through suffering you gain pleasure or be joyous. Now there are two systems. You suffer or you enjoy everything and suffer later. Only there are two systems now in the world. Enjoy everything in your younger age, IT industry, go work, get all money.